Hey guys, welcome to the 11th lecture of the DIP series. This is Anushree and today we're going to talk about histogram matching, also known as specification. Now, if you haven't watched the previous videos yet, especially the one on histogram equalization, then kindly do so before watching this one. Now, we have a question here. Given below are two histograms 1 and 2. Modify histogram 1 as given by histogram 2. So we have the gray level and the number of pixel values for both of these histograms. And based on these values, what we'll do first is draw the two histograms. Now, as you can see, I have drawn the two histograms, the first one and the second one. The gray level is represented on the x-axis and the number of pixels on the y-axis. So if you look here, 0, the value is 80. So I've drawn 80 here, marked 80. 1, it is 100. So we have marked 100. For 2 it is 90, so 90, and so on. We have taken a scale of 20 here, okay, 20, 40, 60, 80, like that. And even for this one, the first three values are 0, so we have marked 0. Then for 3 it is 60, so we have marked 60, and so on. Now the next step is to equalize the first histogram. So we have drawn the table for the first histogram here. Now we have to follow the same steps what we did in histogram equalization. So we have written down the gray level and the NK values here. We calculated the total NK value here, which comes out to be 390. Then we calculate PDF, or also known as P of RK, which is nothing but NK by N. So here 80 by 390, this comes out to be the value. 100 by 390, this comes out to be the value, and so on. Next, we calculate CDF, also known as SK. So here we just directly take this value, and then we take the sum of these two values, which comes out to be 0.45. Then sum of these two values, which comes out to be 0.68. Sum of these two values, 0.83, and so on. In the next column, we just multiply this column by 7. Why 7? Because this R interval is from 0 to 7. So these comes out to be the values. Next, histogram equalization. We're just rounding off these values. This column values, when we round off, we get these values. And next, we have new NK values. Now, how do we get this column? See, we have one here for which the NK value is 80. So we'll just write down 80 here. Next is 3, so we'll take this 100 and write it down here. Next, even for 5, we'll do the same step. But for 6, we have two 6s here. So what we'll do is, we'll take the sum of these two, which is 60 plus 30, 90. We'll write down 90 here. For next, it is 7 3 times. So we'll take the sum of these 3, which comes out to be 30. We write down 30 here. Now the next step is equalize histogram 2. So again, we follow the same steps. Okay, we write down the gray level values, the NK values, the sum, which is 390 again. PDF we'll calculate, CDF we'll calculate, into 7, SK into 7 we'll calculate, and the histogram equalization level. Now here we don't have to write the new NK values. Okay, we just stop it here. Now the next step is mapping. So here what we'll do is, we'll take the first and last columns of the histogram 2 and take the last two columns of the histogram 1. So this is the histogram 2, we've taken the first and last columns, and this is histogram 1, we've taken the last two columns. Now we have to do the mapping. So for mapping, what we'll do is, we'll look at these two values. Here for these three values, the values are 0. Okay, here the histogram equalization levels are 0. So let's just leave this for now. We'll start with this one. For the gray level 3, the histogram equalization level is 1. When we check this one in this table, then the nearest histogram equalization level here is 1 here. So for that the new nk value is 80. Therefore, for 3 we'll mark the value as 80. So now if we take this new table here, then for 3 we'll mark it as 80. Next, for 4 we have the value as 2. Now if we check 2 in this table, we don't have 2 here. So what we'll do is we'll take the nearest histogram equalization level. Now we have 1 and 3, we have 2 options here, right? So in that case, we need to make sure that this value is greater than this value, okay? So we can't map it with 3, therefore we'll map it with 1. Okay, so we always need to make sure that the histogram equalization level of the target histogram is greater than the original histogram. So therefore we have marked this with this, okay, this 2 with 1. Next comes 4. Now again, 4, the nearest histogram equalization level is 3, so we'll mark this 4 with 3. The answer would come out to be 100. So let's just write down these values. For 4, the answer will come 80. For 5, the answer will come out to be 100. So we write it down in this table. Next comes 6. Now for 6, we have 6 value in this table. So we'll just directly mark it here. And then this value will come out to be 90. So we write down 90 here. Okay, why not 5? Because we have to take the nearest histogram equalization level. Okay, if 6 is there, we won't take 5. But if 6 wasn't there, we would have taken the nearest, which would be 5. For 7, we have the value here, which is 30. So for 7, we'll mark it as 30. Now the first 3 values, it was 0 here, so we'll just take it as 0. So this comes out to be our final result, after which we draw the histogram for this. Now based on this table, we have drawn our final histogram here. For the first 3 values, the values are 0. Then the next gray level, for 3 it is 80, so we have marked 80 here. For 4 again 80, for 5 it's 100, for 6 it's 90, and 7 it is 30. So this comes out to be our final histogram after mapping. That's it for this lecture. I will see you in the next one.